person would go onto the net to search information or, you know, get information. But then I realized with time and with experience, there's a lot of stuff on the net that cannot be used. Because with experience, you realize that sometimes those things are not suitable for your body. Or, you know, your gene type or, you know, where you come from. What works for a Chinese person may not work for you, you know. And who could also tell you more about that. But as far as I'm concerned, see, we have done things like gana hota hai. One, you know, 3 days before a song, you have to wear a ghagra choli and your waist has to look in shape. So whatever you've done before that, you want to forget. So you start having stuff that is going to be anti-bloating, asparagus ka soup piliya, because, you know, it works with the diuretic. And I've done stuff like that, and those things have worked. So with time and with experience, you realize with doing stuff, what works for you, what doesn't work for you, and what can commonly work, you know, for other people. Like something like a ginger lemon honey with jaggery, if not honey, then some people are allergic to honey, works brilliantly for a cold. And if you put a bit of black pepper with warm water, it's just something that will work, and it's all Indian. So yeah, and then even neembu pani, you know, as a coolant. Those are all very simple things. Ghee ko kaise banaya jata hai, ye maine bola hai book mein, likha hai maine book mein, ye sadiyon se chalta aa raha hai mere family mein, to aur itna simple hai. So I've tried to use those things in my life, and I put it in my book, and I've used it all throughout my career and my life.
Shilpa, we've seen a lot of authors. For you, what was the most challenging part of penning this book?
See, you know, for me, I have to be honest, it was a learning curve. Now, who's going to believe me? Or I'm not even an authority to be talking about, you know, BMR and HDL and, you know, stuff like that. I could break down stuff. I learned things like, you know, ghee has butyric acid. You know, it stimulates a fluid in your intestine that actually increases your metabolism and helps you digest food. So this book was a complete learning curve, and I actually became half a nutritionist with Luke, because we would discuss things in detail. And there were a lot of thoughts in my mind, which I put down on paper, and Luke would actually do interviews with me. Okay, what is it that you want to talk about? What is it that you think we can, you know, do in terms of a change? And we actually ended up coming to just one thing. It was a lifestyle modification. It was a discipline. Like my discipline, and you know, the word discipline may sound very harsh, but it isn't. When you say discipline, you can even call it a mantra. Like my mantra is, I don't eat after 8:30. That's my discipline. So it's not difficult to do. You have to just put your head, you know, mind to it. And it's as simple as that. So yes, putting those points down on paper and how it comes across, and then you have somebody of Luke's stature authenticating it with his knowledge, with his vast expertise and experience. That was, you know, that amalgam, to bring about that amalgam was very difficult. But I, you know, he and I are actually two sides of the same coin, and there are no egos. I don't want any credit here. I just, Luke and I have done this book together because we wanted people to become healthier. And not everybody can afford a nutritionist. I don't think even I also can afford Luke. But we wanted people to understand how simple it was in life to become healthy. Forget weight loss. So we put our minds together, and this book and all that I have said has come from my heart. So this book truly is for those people, for those mothers who have just given birth, whose responsibility it is to look after their family's health. You know, the health of a child, of another human being, it's so important. Unfortunately, for most people, we look at health, or we look at bettering our health when it becomes bad. And one of the biggest reasons I decided to you know, write this book was for a lot of cases of cancer that I saw passed away with cancer. I realized another uncle was diagnosed with cancer, and another one of my aunties had it. And there were very few, there were very close people around me who's, you know, somebody from their family suffered with it. Cancer isn't something that is just happening because there's some genetic issue. There is obviously an issue with what we are doing in our lives, our lifestyle. And I think it's time that we kind of put into practice the line, precaution is better than cure, which is why we have written this book. If the West, I'm pretty flexible, you do what you want to do, I'm doing my bit, so the choice is yours.
Hi Shilpa, hi Luke, this is Ekta from Lifestyle Blog. First of all, it's quite a mammoth Herculean task to co-author a book, so kudos to both of you and congratulations for pulling it together. So my question to both of you is that, you know, no wonder the book is going to be great. I mean, the kind of you know, stuff you're talking about just talks a lot of substance about the book that will be holding. I just want to ask both of you, what are the challenges that you faced while writing this book? Challenges in terms of maybe coordination, but in terms of, you know, bringing this information, because this is going to be a global book, I guess. So what are those challenges according to both of you?
I'm going to let Luke answer that.
Challenge is finding time to get her to do this. She travels a lot, I travel a lot, so we met when we could, we would discuss the subject. If we were in different countries, she would call me with an idea, I would call her with an idea, and if we agreed on it, we would make that into a chapter. So I think over, that's the reason the book took over 2.5 years. You know, we've been putting things together, and we sat down and said, okay, now we need to, you know, put it all together. So I think challenge-wise, there's a lot of information that exists. I mean, you Google, last night I Googled the best diet in the world, the best exercise program in the world, and I got 4.26 crore results. Those are so many different options, which means so much of confusion and so much of fear. So how do you take information which is right, organize it, and deliver it to people? So there's a lot of wisdom of Indian food in the Vedas. So we went back into that old history to make sure that the knowledge we choose to share is aligned with wisdom and ancient Indian history.
Hi, Shiva, this question is for you. Hi, firstly, congratulations on the book. Tell us, before being a writer, you are a movie star. How big a fan of James Bond are you?
I can see that digression is inevitable. And I can also foresee what the next question is going to be. So very quickly, and making a sharp exit, I'm going to steer it towards
I just want to know, because it's quite an big issue.
Does James Bond eat Indian food?
No, but do you...
Does he eat Indian food? But you know, does he eat Indian food?
But you know, Shilpa, we don't meet you very often, and that was going to be my question over here. So to your
I'll
be
meeting
you
on the 25th, there's another press conference.
But, no, but right now, we just, you know, just paraphrasing what she was trying to say, is you're talking about the great Indian diet over here. You know, India has its own ups and downs, and we're dealing with so many pressures. And as a movie star, someone who belongs wholeheartedly to the film industry, there's quite a bit of, you know, up and down happening there as well, censorship issues and other things. As an actor and a very integral part of it, any thoughts, nothing controversial.
I honestly don't know where this is going, but what is the question?
No,
I don't know what's happening.
Shilpa, James Bond's movie is released tomorrow, and the kissing scene in the film has been reduced on
50%. What because my husband's not
going
to like that. No, but how? What do you want me to say?
So about the censor board, you know, deleting scenes.
I didn't know that the censor board, Indian censor board, has the right over deleting it.
Yes, for India.
See, I'm so dumb, I don't know. I have no idea. I've been so engrossed and so crazily involved in this book and the release, you have no idea. I had Hrithik who missed a flight in the morning.
But Shilpa, as an audience,
I think about a kissing scene that was deleted.
But as an audience, would you like it as somebody who's, who follows cinema?
See, when I go to watch a movie, I obviously, I'm not only going to see the kissing scene, am I? I just want to see the film in totality. But I'm sure there'll be a lot of men out there who would be very upset. Thank you very much, sir.
बंद करो बस करो
हाँ जी सी देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग अगर आप फ्रेश फूड खा रहे हैं अगर आप घर का बना हुआ खा रहे हैं और अगर आप बच्चे हैं तो आप कुछ भी खा सकते हैं कुछ भी बर्न आउट कर सकते हैं लेकिन एज यू ग्रो ओल्डर लाइक यू नो देयर इज I don't know if it's a belief or if it really is true, but they say that there's a body shift that happens, a shift that happens in your body every 12 years, which slows down your metabolism. So, जहाँ तक बच्चों को पराठे खिलाने की बात है, या आपको अगर आपकी मम्मी ने पराठे खिलाए दो से ज़्यादा, तो प्लीज़ उनको बोलिए नहीं, क्योंकि अब आप बच्चे नहीं हैं, हाँ? नहीं, लेकिन ये जो कॉन्सेप्ट है कि अरे बच्चा बहुत पतला है और उसे मोटा कर देना चाहिए बहुत ही अजीब ख्याल है क्योंकि ज़रूरी नहीं है कि अगर आपका बच्चा थोड़ा सा पतला है इसका मतलब वो हेल्दी नहीं है मेरा बच्चा बहुत मोटा भी नहीं है पतला भी नहीं है वो हेल्दी है एंड आई नेवर गिवन टू मच आई नेवर पेड टू मच अटेंशन टू द फैक्ट दैट माई सन इज गोल्ड मटोल विच मोस्ट इंडियन मदर्स थिंक इज लाइक अ प्री रिक्विजिट फॉर अ बेबी टू लुक हेल्दी तो इनफैक्ट आज के पीडियाट्रिशियंस कहते हैं कि आप अपने बच्चे को डाइट पे डाल दीजिए अगर आपका बच्चा एक पर्टिकुलर वेट से ज़्यादा हो तो दे आर वेरी कॉन्शियस एंड इवन टुडेज गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट दे ट्रेन यू व्हाइल यू आर प्रेग्नेंट टू मेक श्योर दैट यू टेक केयर ऑफ योर हेल्थ एंड न्यूट्रिशन एंड योर बेबी शुडन्ट बी यू नो ओवरवेट यू शुडन्ट बी ओवरवेट बिकॉज इट इज ओनली
अरे मैं बाइट ले रहा हूं तुम किधर हो
इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ यू नो
Delivery.
So, there has been a lot of changes पहले और अब तो
अंदर हूँ मैं
जहाँ तक इस बुक की बात है और इंडियन डाइट की बात है I completely practice what I preach and मैं खाती हूँ मैं घी खाती हूँ रोज खाती हूँ बहुत बहुत सालों से खाती आई हूँ और I really think it helps my bones it helps memory it helps my hair तो आई प्रिस्क्राइब इट टू वन एंड ऑल घी खाना कोई बुरी बात नहीं है आप जो भी करें अपनी जिंदगी में वो आप मॉडरेशन के साथ करें तो मॉडरेशन इज रियली द की वर्ड ओवर हियर और हाँ आप जिंदगी में जो भी खाना चाहे बस वो खाएं देयर इज नथिंग रॉन्ग विद दैट्स व्हाट वी हैव सेड